Take my moment.
Take my moment and my day.
Let them flow.
Let them flow.
In ceaseless praise.
Father God, we worship you in this place. We exalt and we magnify your holy name. Father God, we have come to meet with you today, O God. We surrender all unto you in the mighty name of Jesus. As we have praised you, as we have worshipped you, O God, we pray, Lord God Almighty, that the heavens will be opened unto us even in this place. That you will take everything that we have, O God, and you will mold it to your glory in the mighty name of Jesus, including the seeds, O God, our children that we have brought before your altar, even in this place today. We say, come and have your way amongst us. Come and do what only you alone can do. We cannot have this gathering of mothers, oh God, in this place without your presence and without your power. Father God, come and move in your power. Come and move in your glory. In the mighty name of Jesus, come and do what only you alone can do. That at the end of the day, oh God, your word, oh God, will speak even in their lives. All that we will do in this place, oh God, we will see the fruits of it in the mighty name of Jesus. Thank you, Lord God Almighty. Thank you for those that are still on their way. We pray that you will bring them here safely. And for us that are here, let our spirit man be open to that which you want to do. We declare we will not pray amiss. We will pray your word. We will shoot your word as an arrow to mold the destinies of these children. In the mighty name of Jesus, you that is the ultimate creator, we pray that you will be here, O God, to create their destiny and to mold them after your image. In Jesus' mighty name, we have worshipped. Amen. Praise the Lord. Let's give the Lord a round of applause. Let's worship the Almighty God, the one with whom all things are possible, the Creator, the King of Kings, and the Lord of Lords. Father God, we worship you. We bless your holy name. You may be seated even in the presence of the Almighty God. Amen. This morning, I just want to welcome each and every one of you, even onto the Speak to Your Seed program, a gathering of praying mothers and mothers-to-be. We thank God for your life, and my prayer for each and every one of you is that as you have come out today, your coming out will not be in vain in the mighty name of Jesus. I welcome you on behalf of the pastor in charge of the Jesus Women Ministries, Pastor Omor Gandiola Oye, our mommy, and the visionary of this ministries, and on behalf of the Jesus Women Ministry and, of course, the Home Builders Ministry who has put this together, who is actually hosting this event. Amen? I want all of us, as we have come out, we are here to build legacies. We are here to establish our generation. We are here to speak into the lives of our children. I want you to know that as you do so, the Lord will not only hear, but he will answer. In the mighty name of Jesus. The Bible says in Psalm 127:3, it says that, lo, children are the heritage of the Lord, and the fruit of the womb is his reward. We have come to partner with him that says that children belongs to him. They are his heritage. They are his inheritance. And as we partner up with him in the mighty name of Jesus, he will shape the destinies of these children. The Bible also says in that verse 4, it says that as arrows are in the hands of a mighty man, just like you take an arrow and you shoot it to the direction to which you want. We are going to be praying targeted prayers here. We are going to be speaking the word of God here in the mighty name of Jesus. The word of God that is quick and powerful, that is sharper than any two-edged sword, that is able to go to the intent of the thoughts and the minds of these children and mold them until Christ be fully formed in them by faith in the mighty name of Jesus. Are you all ready today? Are you all ready today? To pray for your destiny, to pray for your legacy. God says he desires a godly seed. So we're going to give him that godly seed that he so desires, even in the place of prayer. Quick, for us to be on the same page, I just want to lay five things for us to let you know the weapon that you have as mothers. To let you know the weapon that you have as children of God. And then we're going to rise to our feet and we're going to pray. I want you to know that as a child of God, you have the power to create. As a mother, you have the power to create the sort of life that you want these children to have. The Bible says that in the beginning, God created the heavens and the earth. And what did he do? He spoke the word. He said, let there be light. And there was light. So you're able to speak exactly what you want in your children's life. Proverbs 18:21 says, death and life is in the power of the tongue. And they that love it shall eat the fruit of it. I want you to begin to speak to the Lord that you will eat the fruit of your word today as you speak into the lives of your children, as you speak life in the mighty name of Jesus. The Bible also says in John 6:63, it is the spirit that quickeneth. The flesh profited not. He says, the words that I speak unto you, they are spirit and they are life. I want you to begin to speak to the Lord, even where you are seated, that the words that you will speak concerning your children today, to shape their destiny, they will be life in the mighty name of Jesus. Amen? As many as are here desiring children, trusting in the Lord for children, you are not left out. You don't have to wait for the children to come in order to be able to speak into their destiny. Anna came to Shiloh. She settled the destiny and the life of Samuel. The Bible says we can call those things that be not, even before they come forth. Amen? Because our God calls those things that be not. So this is your time to call forth those children, to call forth to come and fulfill their destiny and purpose here on earth in the mighty name of Jesus. You also have the power to forbid, and you have the power to release. What does it mean to forbid? To forbid what you do not want in their lives. To release them into the grace and into the anointing and to the purpose for which God called them to. The Bible says in Matthew 16 verse 9, he said, and I have given unto thee the keys of the kingdom of heaven, that whatsoever you bind on earth, that is whatsoever you forbid on earth in their lives, will be forbidden in heaven. Whatsoever you bind on earth will be bound in heaven. Whatsoever you shall lose on earth. So whatever you release into their lives will come to pass in the mighty name of Jesus. Heaven will back you up. The Bible says in Mark 11:20, said, verily I say unto you, whosoever shall speak unto that mountain, be thou removed. Every mountain, every challenge in their lives, we are here to remove it. So you have the power to forbid and release. You have the power to create, to bring life. Amen? You have the power to do warfare and for your warfare to be accomplished. The Bible says, for the weapons of our warfare are not carnal, but they are mighty through God to the pulling down of strongholds, casting down every imagination, every high thing that has exalted itself against the knowledge of God in the lives of your children will be uprooted today in the mighty name of God. I'm telling you all this so that you know who you are in Christ Jesus, the power that you have as a mother, amen? Power to forbid and release, power to speak life, power to do warfare, and for your warfare to be established, for your warfare in the mighty name of Jesus to be accomplished. You also have the power to restore. There's going to be some things we need to restore in the lives of our children. Amen? You are going to speak the word, and the word will restore in the mighty name of Jesus. Do you remember when Jesus was at the grave of Lazarus? After he prayed, he spoke the word, and he called Lazarus forth. And the Bible says everything that made him bound, he was released. Amen? And he came back. Because he had not yet fulfilled his purpose. Amen? So, and we're going to call every dry bones. We're going to speak and prophesy. Every dry bone must come alive. When the word of God came on Ezekiel, he said, every dry bone must come alive. He said, because that was the exceeding great army that God had for the children of Israel. Every dry bone in your children's life, I don't know, it could be sickness, it could be a debilitating disease, it could be a special needs issue, it could be a neurological disease, it could, whatever it is, in the mighty name of Jesus, that dryness must receive the life of God, even in this place, in Jesus' mighty name. And the word of God will prosper, because it will not return back unto him void. The word that you will speak today will not, it will accomplish that purpose in the mighty name of Jesus. They say everything will pass away, but the word of God endureth forever. I want us to rise to our feet this morning. I'm going into my session, even at this time. And my session this morning is for us to pray that our children will discover, they will understand, and they will fulfill and maximize their potential. They will be relevant in their generation. The Bible says in Jeremiah 1, in Jeremiah chapter 1, verse 4 to 5, which we're all aware of this scripture. He says, the word of the Lord came unto me. He was testifying that the word of the Lord came unto him and said, before I formed thee, I knew you in your mother's womb. Before you were put in the womb, he says, I created you and I sanctified, ordained thee to be a prophet. Let's begin to pray that our children will discover their purpose. He says, the word of the Lord came unto me. The word of the Lord will come unto them. In the mighty name of Jesus, they will discover who they are in Christ Jesus. They don't have to be old for them to discover. They don't have to be a young adult from an early age. In the mighty name of Jesus, they will discover who they are in Christ Jesus. They will discover their purpose. They will understand their calling in the mighty name of Jesus. They will know who they are in Christ Jesus. For those that are here desiring children, begin to speak to the Lord, because God said, before your children were formed in your womb, before they came forth, he knew them and sanctified them. Begin to pray that the Lord, in the mighty name of Jesus, will set them apart for his glory, will set them apart for his purpose, in the mighty name of Jesus. They will know who they are in Christ Jesus. They will discover who they are. The Lord will empower them. Ordain means to empower, to release his abilities, even in their life. Let's begin to pray. When God calls you, he makes provision. He empowers you. He gives you the strength. He gives you the enabling power. The Lord will empower them. The Lord will give them the enabling power to be able to succeed, to be able to excel, to be able to maximize their potential. In the mighty name of Jesus. Oh, Father God, we bless you. Father God, we give you glory. In Jesus' mighty name we pray. In the same attitude of prayer, the Bible makes us realize, still in Jeremiah 1 verse 6, it says, but Jeremiah answered and said, ah, Lord, behold, I cannot speak, for I am a child. But the Lord said unto me, say not you are a child. Say not that you are immature. Say not that you don't have the ability. Don't look down on yourself. Don't have a low self-image or a low self-esteem about yourself. Don't be intimidated. That's what the word is saying. And the Lord commanded him, thou shalt speak. Be not afraid of their faces. With thee I will deliver you, says the Lord. Do not be afraid of their faces. Then the Lord put forth his hand and gave him something to say. He said that, I have set thee before you today. Set thee before you over the nations, over the kingdoms, to root out, to pull down. Let's begin to pray. Our children will not be intimidated. They will step out in faith. They will not be intimidated. From an early age, they will be able to stand and speak. From an early age, they will be able to direct and know exactly what God has called them to be. They will not be intimidated. They will not have low self-esteem. In the mighty name of Jesus, they will not be fearful. They will be confident, knowing that the greater one dwells in the inside of them. In the mighty name of Jesus, begin to pray for them. Mention them by name. They can do all things through Christ who strengthens them. Greater is he that is in them than he that is in the world. The Lord is able to do exceedingly, abundantly, above all that they can ever ask or think, through the power of God that worketh within them. Begin to pray that the Holy Ghost will begin to work within them. In the mighty name of Jesus, they will do exceedingly and abundantly. For the past spirit of the Lord allows them to be able to do that which he has called them to do. In the mighty name of Jesus, God, David, who was young, came to the camp of Israel and said, who is that uncircumcised Philistine that wants to destroy the children of the Most High God? Even though his brother condemned him and told him that you are just but a child, he said, is there not a cause? Is there not a cause? Is there not a cause? Let's pray that we have that same spirit that rested upon David, that we know who they are in Christ. In the mighty name of Jesus. Oh, Father God, we bless you. We give you praise in Jesus' mighty name. I want us to still pray. Jeremiah 1, 11 to 12 says that, moreover, the word of the Lord now came unto him, saying, Jeremiah, what seest thou? And he said, I see a rod and an almond tree. Because that rod of the almond, he was not supposed to blossom at that time. But God made him see his potential, where he's taking him to. And he said, you have well seen. He said, then the Lord said unto me, that as well seen, for I will hasten my word to perform. Begin to pray that as from now, our children will begin to enter into their purpose in the mighty name of Jesus. The Bible says, before Zion travailed, she brought forth. Before her pain came, she was delivered. Who has seen such a thing? Can a nation be born in a day? They will begin to enter into their purpose in the mighty name of Jesus. The Lord will hasten to perform. Begin to pray that the Lord will open their eyes of understanding. The Lord will give unto them the spirit of wisdom and revelation in the knowledge of him. In the mighty name of Jesus, they will not fail. They will not falter in Jesus' mighty name. In Jesus' mighty name. Still praying for them to maximize their potential. I want us to begin to pray that an excellent spirit will dwell in them. The spirit of God is an excellent spirit. That spirit will make them outstanding in their area of skill, in their vocation, in their academics, in their skills, in their talents. An excellent spirit will rest upon them. In the mighty name of Jesus, they will be outstanding. They will be first among equal. They will be the head and not the tail. They will be above only and not beneath. Everywhere they go, in the community, in church, in their schools, in the seat of government, they will occupy when they grow up. They will be masters and occupy in the seat of government, in the church, in the mighty name of Jesus, in technology, in healthcare, everywhere they go, in the mighty name of Jesus. The Bible says that Daniel had an excellent spirit. He was preferred among the presidents, among the princes. In the mighty name of Jesus, our children will stand out. They will be preferred. They will be showcased in Jesus' mighty name. Another prayer I want us to pray. It is one thing to be successful. It is another thing for your character to sustain you. There was a conference I went for with Miles Monroe. He said, you might have all the potentials and the abilities to succeed. He said, but character is what sustains you to be on top. Let's begin to pray for their character. The Bible says in Daniel 6, 3 to 4, it says, and then this Daniel was preferred above the president and princes. He said, then the president and princes sought to find occasion against Daniel concerning the kingdom, but they could not find none occasion nor fault. They could not come against him because there was no fault in him. Begin to pray. Our children will have godly character. They will have godly character that will sustain them to be successful. They will have godly character for them to maximize their potential. They will be righteous. They will be holy. They will be self-disciplined in the mighty name of Jesus. They will not subject themselves to the flesh, but to the spirit of God. They will be spirit-led. They will be spirit-ruled in the mighty name of Jesus. Father God, we bless you. In Jesus' mighty name we pray. I have two more prayer points. I want you to begin to pray as well for every limitation in their lives. Begin to approve for everyone that has a child that has a disability. Anyone that has a child that is differently able. Anyone that has a child that has a limitation. The limitation could be a sickness, could be a disease, could be laziness, could be procrastination. Whatever it is, I want us to come against this. Jesus told the disciple, he said, go and bring the coat. And anyone that tells you, do not bring them. Tell them the master has need of them. Begin to mention their name. The master has need of them. Luke 19, verse 30 to 30. The master has need of them. The master has need of them. They have to come to Jesus. They have to serve the Lord. They have to live for him. They have to fulfill their purpose. He says, untie the cord. Untie the cord. We lose them to their destiny and to their purpose. In Jesus' mighty name we pray. Finally, the Bible says in Genesis 1:26, it says that I created, let us make man in our image and in our own likeness. It says, let's create them in our own image. I said he created them male and female. And he says that he blessed them. In this generation where people are saying they don't know who they are in Christ, they make them male, they want to be a woman. They make them a woman, they want to be a male. If the foundation be destroyed, what can the righteous do? If God says, I made you to be a man, a mighty man of valor, you said you want to be a woman, the foundation is faulted. They can never fulfill their purpose. If God says that you are a woman and you decide you want to be a man or marry a man, how can you fulfill your purpose? That means you've told the creator. You are not happy the way he created you. You cannot. Let's come against it. God forbid. God forbid abomination. It will not be found in our lineage. It will not be found in our children. They will know that if they are male, they will know that they are male. And God will bless them. They will be fruitful. They will multiply. They will subdue. They will have dominion. If they are female, the same goes for them. They will be fruitful. They will multiply. They will have dominion. They will subdue in the mighty name of Jesus. Finally, pray for yourself as parents. You will not hinder your children in maximizing their potential. You will not be their hindrance. Tell the Lord to speak to you and your husband that God will direct you concerning their life, concerning their purpose. The Bible says that everything that happened to Jesus, Mary kept it in her heart. She knew, she did not hinder him from going about the Lord's business. Begin to pray. You will not hinder your children from going about the Lord's business. That God should speak to you. God should speak to you in the mighty name. You and your spouse, you will be helper of their destinies. You will be helper of their destinies. In Jesus' mighty name, we have prayed.